Okay. So good evening, my dear brothers and sisters. We are again here on this platform. Let's speak in English with non-native English speakers, and we are like a family. That's why we are not formal now. We are a little bit informal, so we can share our feelings. And today is our host is from Assam, Mr. Subhas Paul sir. So he's our host today. So good luck, Subhas Paul.
Thank you, sir. Sir, shall I begin, sir, now?
Hello.
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 Yeah.
Hello, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you are audible now. So you can start your program. And good luck for that.
Thank you, sir. Good evening, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank Sri Prakash sir for giving me the
Subhas Paul sir. You can start.
Yes, sir. Sir, network is disturbing actually. That's why I had already started,
Hello?
But I think my words did not go to you all. Hello, sir. Hello.
Yes, Subhas sir, you are audible.
Am I audible? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Good evening, everyone. First of all, I would like to thank Sri Prakash Kalal sir for giving me the opportunity to host today's sessions. It is my utmost pleasure to be able to host today's meeting. I will try my level best to share some valuable information, which I hope would benefit everyone. I would also like to make it clear that today I am here not to teach, but to learn something together with all of you. Now I would like to invite Keur Gujarat to deliver the welcome speech.
Okay, so hello and welcome everyone. We every day join on this session and enjoy our every moment. We learn every time new things. We learn new things on this platform. So today, again, we joined at same time on this platform. And today our host is Subhas Paul sir. So I hope we will learn new things on this today's session. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So today our first topic of discussion will be of tenses. The tenses are an important part of English grammar. Tenses help speakers to express time in the language. They are of great use and importance in both ways of communication, verbal and written. Without knowledge of tense, we would never be able to speak correct English. We would discuss together the various forms of tenses. So, sir, now I want to share my document so that we can see the documents. Is it visible to everyone?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. So I would request you one by one to identify the forms of the tense in the sentence. So first, I would like to ask Mr. Keur Gujarat. Just identify the number once.
Yeah, sir. It's a present continuous. She is teaching her student.
Yes, right.
Okay, thank you, sir.
And next, actually, I don't know who are the present. Anybody can come and say the second sentence.
Okay, may I?
Second one. Okay, Tanan.
Okay, so second one is present perfect continuous.
Very good.
Been waiting. Yes, yes, right. The third one, who can go for it?
Simple.
Yes, it's right. The next one.
Present perfect.
Yes. The next, Papia is there?
No.
Shubhasri ma'am?
Then, the one is past perfect.
Yes, ma'am. And the next one is?
May I, sir?
Yes.
Okay, sixth one is?
Past perfect continuous.
Yes.
Yes, right. And who is left? They can go for the next one.
Yeah. Simple future. Seventh one is?
Simple future. Seventh one.
Simple future. Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the next one, eight one, number eight.
Future perfect continuous.
Yeah.
Yes, right. Who is left? I'm gonna go for the next one.
Nine is the future continuous.
Future continuous.
Yes, right. The next one, number 10.
Past negative.
Simple past.
Yes.
Simple past. Yes.
And this one for Joya ma'am. This number 11 for Joya ma'am. Is she there?
Which one I was watching? Hello, am I audible? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh. Your voice is very low.
Past perfect continuous. It is. I was watching.
Yeah, and another. There are two past tense. Another one.
Past continuous.
Yes. 11th one is past continuous.
Yes. The next one.
It is.
Future perfect.
We'll have learned, yes. Achana.
13th one is simple present.
Okay, simple present. When we use this kind of, where we can use this kind of sentences? There is particular.
Some rules. For using the
yes.
It is some universal truth.
When we find this kind of sentences in newspaper headlines, isn't it?
Yes.
Generally, newspaper headlines.
Yes.
And the number 14.
Past.
Present perfect.
Yes, right. Absolutely right. So. From here, I can guess that everyone has very good knowledge about tenses. I never expected. It's very, very, very good. Really, all of our participants are very good in tenses. So there is no doubt they are going to do very much, very well in spoken as well as in writing. So, madam, we can discuss it since we. Say Santa ma'am, you can tell about the thing when we use the past perfect continuous tense. The situation when we use.
Past perfect continuous tense is used in the verb starts in the past. But it is still continuing. At that time, we use the past perfect tense.
Yeah. Right. Okay. Next one for the simple. Nithyananda is there?
Yeah. I'm here.
Sir, excuse me. I think you asked for past perfect tense or present perfect.
The last one I asked for past perfect continuous.
I didn't tell correctly. Yeah, I told about present perfect continuous tense.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
I asked for number 6. That is the past perfect continuous. In which situation? In which situation we use this one?
I had been working. Past perfect. Okay, madam. Jay, madam, continue.
See here, I had been working in this company for 5 years. That means, in the past, one particular time, the work has begun, and at that time, it has been continuing in that moment. And now it is stopped. Here I had been working in this company for 5 years. That means in our past, in that period, 5 years period. So I had been working that. And now still I am not working. In that period, I had been working that. So in that sense, it is using.
So right.
Yeah, work already completed. And in that particular period, it has the work was going on in that period.
Yes. Because in the sentence itself is telling that I had been working in this company for 5 years when I got promotion. Because I got promotion in the past, and before that, I had been working in that company.
I had been working. Yes.
Right. Yes. Absolutely right.
The work started in the past and completed in the past. Is it right, sir? The work started in the past and sometimes it has going on and after it stopped.
Yeah, in that particular time, it has stopped.
Yes.
Started and stopped.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Now, Nithyanand.
Yes, sir.
You can tell us when we use the simple present tense.
Simple present tense. Okay. So, some means eternal truth, and some everyday. What we do daily. Means used to like that type of work.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah. So and sir. So and some means truth events and some kind of work what we do daily. So that is present indefinite.
Yes. Yeah. So you can make one sentence with the universal truth. Can you make one?
Yeah, sun. Revolves earth revolves in the sun
revolves around the sun
around the sun. Okay.
Yes. The sentence okay is very simple. Okay, now I will go.
He goes
I
want to school. Go.
Yes, that is also right.
Okay.
So is Ilarani is there?
Hello. Yes, sir.
Achha.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning. You are in the USA, so you are telling good morning.
Oh,
so
yes,
we are in the evening.
Good evening to all.
Yes. Okay, it's okay. So I want you to describe, the second sentence. You have to tell us when we use the situation, when we use this kind of sentence, this form of sentence.
We have been waiting for them since morning.
Yes.
Okay. I think it's present participle.
No. It is present. It is present perfect continuous.
Okay. Sorry, sir. Actually, I'm very poor with tense.
actually, it's okay.
Here in this screen only we can see you from 6th only.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay. Now? Is it visible?
No.
Now it is visible.
Not visible.
So visible now.
Now visible? Okay.
Yes, it's visible.
So who want to go for that one? Numbers, second. Poppy is there. Has Poppy come? She is not there.
Yes, sir. I'm there.
So you can tell us when, in which situation we use this form of tense.
Which one, sir?
Number second one.
Okay, we have been waiting for them since morning.
Yes.
Okay, so I think as you said, it is a present perfect continuous tense.
Yes.
And we use present perfect continuous tense for an action, means for expressing an action which began, means which began at some time in the past and still continuing.
Yes, right. Absolutely right. Now I want to call Ruchi ma'am. Is there? Ruchi ma'am, are you there? Shubhashri madam, Pankaj Udaipur, are you there? Pankaj Udaipur, hello. Ashok Moria, are you there? Ashok Moria.
Yes, sir.
Ashok Moria, are you there? Hello.
No, sir. No, he is not there.
Okay. So anybody can take say number 5 and tell the situation when we use.
May I, sir? Good evening, sir.
Yes.
I am Pramod. Yes.
Okay.
Sir, it is the past perfect tense.
Yes.
Past perfect tense and situation is he has completed his breakfast very earlier.
Yeah. Okay, it is okay. But generally, what happens is, see, generally past perfect tense we generally use that if there is two events happened in the past. Happened in the which one is more past than the other one? The
more
past. That is past perfect, and the other one is simple past.
Because I am not there, sir. So I have not explained like you, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. Okay, now.
Sir. Shubhaspal, sir.
Yes.
If it is a past perfect tense, we must have two sentences. Because one thing must have happened before the one thing. Suppose. I had eaten my breakfast before I brushed my teeth. Otherwise, after I had eaten my breakfast, comma, I brushed my teeth.
You can tell like this also. You can tell like this also.
There must be one past tense and one past perfect tense. In any past perfect tense follows, always follows past tense also. But in this, I think in this first fifth sentence, he had his breakfast. Here we are using this one, this had, as a verb.
Yeah, the first one is helping verb. The first head is helping verb, and the second head is acting as main verb. And the first head is helping verb. So that's why had. So yes, ma'am.
Past perfect tense. Past perfect tense must follow. Must have two sentences.
Yes, ma'am.
And that two, those two sentences will combine with before, after, or when. That's all.
Yes, ma'am. As you said, I can give you one example. As soon as I reached the station, the train had left. Before I reaching the station, the train had already left. So I could not catch the train.
Almost all the sentences will have two sentences and follow with the combined with the before, after, and then.
Yes. Here in this can sentence, make, also you can say that. Yeah.
Can yes. I make one sentence, sir?
Yes, sir. Please.
Okay, sir. Thank you. He had his breakfast before his father came to house.
Absolutely. I was going to tell this one also.
Yes, thank you.
Right, sir. Okay.
And so that in that situation, you can use this sentence. After we must have another sentence and combine with before or after. When.
Yes.
Almost yes. All yes. The sentences. Yes. Then only we will use.
Correct. That is called.
Yes, ma'am. You are absolutely right. But here we just asked the form of the sentence. That's why I have not written the full sentence. I asked for the sentence.
No problem.
So since I have told in the beginning that I am not here to teach anybody because I also don't know anything. So we are discussing. So anybody can share here whatever they know about the tenses. If there is any particular thing that want to share, they can share.
Generally, some tenses confuse, sir. For everyone, we must have
tenses. Absolutely.
So, it is very difficult subject to discuss.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, remembering all the grammar is very difficult.
But I'm very happy to know just today that everybody who told, all of them were correct.
Even some tenses we use in the written form only. We don't never use in the spoken form.
Yes.
It's a very nice topic, sir.
Grammatically.
It is important also.
Yes, it's very, very important.
While writing, it is used.
Yes.
But I am very poor in tense.
No, everyone is poor in tense. As I said, it is a very difficult, sir.
Yes.
We don't know everything about tenses, but we can't.
I want to ask one question. Anybody can take it.
Okay.
This sentence is made, in the form of simple past. Okay. But the incident happened in future. The incident is going to happen in future, but it expresses in simple present tense. Can you give any example?
Simple present tense.
We express in simple present tense, but it happens in future. Can you give any example?
Okay, I'm going to Bangalore tomorrow.
Going to
like that we can
yeah
no going to will not do na
not continuous, just asking
simple,
for
simple. Simple present tense, ma'am. Okay. Simple present tense.
Okay, okay, okay. So it is this way. Our PM Modi arrives tomorrow. This way?
Yes.
Yeah.
PM Modi arrives tomorrow. Okay. When it is definite, we know, sure, when we are sure about that.
Yes, yes.
We can use it.
My, yes. So one sentence is like that. My flight will depart at 9 o'clock tomorrow. Sorry, not will.
No,
My flight departs at 9 o'clock tomorrow. That is, we have already planned that I will go. We will go somewhere. We have already planned it. That will go.
Yes, yes.
In that case.
Sure. We are sure okay. About
for planned actions, we can use a simple past. A simple past.
Yes, yes.
So may I construct one sentence? Okay. So
yes.
He leaves his job next week.
His job next week. No, yeah. It is not a correct sentence.
He leaves his job next week.
Is going to leave.
No.
So he has already. Planned this.
Yes. I can understand.
Yeah. He. It's a decided plan.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
So he needs a job in some particular term. So it is definitely happen.
Yes. Yes. Right. It means that he has already decided. So he.
Yes.
Correct. So if it is over, then we can go to the next slide, no, ma'am? What do you say?
Yes, yes, too.
Yes. Actually, I don't know how many participants are there. So if anybody left out, they may come voluntarily. Okay.
Okay, sir, you carry on. Okay, sir.
So here, the document is visible?
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So here,
1, 2 is not visible. 1 is not visible.
Now it's clear.
Now? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
1 to 11, 1 to 12.
Okay, I can change it. So there are some mistakes in the sentences, so we have to correct it. So everybody can take one after another.
First one, I have made a mistake.
Yes, correct.
Sir, 18th one, I prefer coffee to tea. 18th one.
I
prefer coffee to tea.
I am living in the USA.
No.
Wrong.
Here is.
Sir, I will take an exam.
Yes. Yes. I live in USA.
She
married to a doctor.
To a doctor. She married to a doctor.
Yes. Right. Okay. Now I'll ask you. About third. Its third is done. So I live in USA. What is wrong there?
I live in the USA.
Yeah, right. Yes. Right. Can you explain it? Can you why there will be the
if we use USA and UA is the short form of the any country. No. So we should use the
because
instead of the America. Yes.
It's unique. Yeah. It's unique country, so that's why you have to use the article.
Now, if you say, let me tell you, I live in America, whether it is correct or wrong.
Correct.
It's a correct.
America is correct. America is correct.
Yeah, but when it is used, then we use the.
I live in the USA. Yes.
Mm.
So fifth one, what is wrong there?
Since instead of four.
For 3 years. For 3 months.
Yes, right.
Yes.
And now sixth one.
Listen.
He does not listen to me.
To me.
Okay. Seventh one.
Anybody.
Yes.
How many children is a plural? My husband is an engineer.
Yes.
He does not have.
Why does? Can anyone tell?
Because it is third person
singular.
Third person singular.
Yes. Very good. Now next one, 11.
By walking.
By bus.
I come to office by walking.
No. By bus. We should use bus. Vehicles only.
I came to office by walking. We cannot use walk.
You just think another thing, another word.
I came to office by
car. I am just giving a hint that we cannot use walk. Instead of walk, we have to use something else.
I came to office by my foot.
Who said on foot?
On Milan.
It's correct. It's on foot. I can do this on foot.
Yeah.
Next one, 12. By car
we can use because
by car, to okay, it's right. But in this particular sense, because walking.
You can use by foot instead of walking.
By foot is not by on foot.
On foot.
When we use any vehicle, that time we can say the by that.
By car, by train.
Yeah, that is true.
With the vehicles, we use by and that by preposition.
Yeah, that is right.
Next one, 12.
What is the time?
By your watch is correct.
By your watch is correct.
Yeah.
Okay.
Number 13.
Our classroom is at the second floor.
No. It is on the second floor.
On the second.
Her hair is not singular. I mean, we can use the verb with singular.
No, it is not correct. We can use hairs in our... No, here it's okay. Here we cannot use hairs. It will be
hair. I am saying that hair is uncountable. That is not hairs. Like, we can't use pimples. It is people. People, it's
no, no, in plural. There is some differences here. Let me tell you. When we take hair as a whole, okay? As a whole... We cannot, when we take hair as a whole, we say hair. like in this case, her hair is black. But you think of the situation. Suppose you have been given a hello.
Yes, sir.
Suppose you have been served dinner, and on that plate you have found two or three hairs. In that case, you can use. You have to use hairs.
Right.
Yeah. It is not that we cannot use hairs. In this particular situation, hair. But when we use two hairs, three hairs, we can use that.
It's, yes, sir. Excuse me. In grammar, in English grammar, for every rule, there is an exception.
Pardon, ma'am?
In every rule,